In this video, you will learn everything you need to know about the James Webb Space Telescope. From how it will help unlock the secrets of the early universe to the controversies of the person after whom the James Webb Space Telescope is named. And you will also learn if NASA will change its name. Webb will be the most powerful, sophisticated, and large-scale space telescope ever developed and deployed into orbit. With longer wavelength coverage and significantly increased sensitivity, the James Webb Space Telescope is an orbiting infrared observatory that will complement and expand the Hubble Space Telescope's findings. Webb can gaze considerably closer to the beginning of time and seek for the undetected birth of the earliest galaxies, as well as peek within dust clouds where stars and planetary systems are developing now, thanks to the longer wavelengths. So you can even call it a time machine, which will have a profound impact on our knowledge of the cosmos. There are several supermassive black holes and quasars that are millions to billions of times the mass of the Sun. They are far away and active. They feed on the infalling matter and unleash spectacular floods of radiation. They are often found in the cores of galaxies. Quasars will be used by Webb to reveal the secrets of the early universe. Quasars are amongst the brightest objects in the universe. Their brightness outshines the combined light of all the stars in their host galaxy, and their jets and winds affect the galaxy in which they live. A team of scientists will train NASA's James Webb Space Telescope on six of the most distant and bright quasars shortly after its launch later this year. Webb will gaze back in time as it looks far into the universe. The light from these faraway quasars began its journey to Webb billions of years ago when the universe was still relatively young. We will see things as they were long ago, not as they are today. Santiago Arribas, a research professor at the Department of Astrophysics of the Center for Astrobiology in Madrid, Spain, said, "All these quasars we are studying existed very early when the universe was less than 800 million years old, or less than 6% of its current age. So these observations give us the opportunity to study galaxy evolution and supermassive black hole formation and evolution at these very early times. The expansion of space has stretched the light from these very far away objects. Cosmological redshift is the term for this phenomenon. The longer light has to travel, the more redshifted it becomes. In fact, the visible light emitted in the early cosmos is stretched so far that when it reaches us, it is moved into the infrared. Webb is specially equipped to examine this type of light because of its set of infrared-tuned equipment. Webb is an extremely sensitive telescope, able to detect very low levels of light. This is important because even though the quasars are intrinsically very bright, the ones this team is going to observe are among the most distant objects in the universe. In fact, they are so distant that the signals Webb will receive are very, very low. Only with Webb's exquisite sensitivity can this science be accomplished. Webb also provides excellent angular resolution, making it possible to disentangle the light of the quasar from its host galaxy. James Webb is the largest telescope ever built. The sun shield is the size of a tennis court, and the primary mirror is 21 feet 4 inches. But Webb's size is too big, so it cannot directly fit into any existing rocket. So it needs to be folded and then it will fit inside the Ariane 5 rocket. Once lifted to space, the Webb telescope will be slowly unfolded. This unfolding step involves a few stages. Solar panel will be deployed first to fulfill the power requirements. After 12 hours, thrusters will be started to tune it into the orbit. After 24 hours, the high-gain antenna is deployed. This will enable communications with ground. Webb will pass the moon in 2 days with its extraordinary velocity. Then the second thruster will start burning to help Webb reach its orbit. On day 3, Webb's special pallets will deploy, revealing its essential sun shield. At first the rear pallet, then the back pallet will deploy. Then Webb's central tower will be extended to make Webb operational in its location. Webb's momentum flap will be deployed after that. This will help Webb stay stable from the sun's radiation pressure. Spatial covers holding Webb's sunshield will now be released. The first of its sunshield mid-booms will be unfolded at this point. Then the second one will deploy. Then the sunshield will be slowly tensioned. This will separate the five layers. At the 10th day, the MIRI instrument's temperature will be brought down nearly to minus 267 degrees Celsius. Just 6 degrees above absolute zero. Now the optical instruments will be deployed. At first, the secondary mirror is deployed. Then an additional radiator panel behind the telescope deploys. This helps to remove heat from the spacecraft. About 4 days after launch, the first wing of the primary mirror is rotated into place. A few days later, the second one. After 30 days of launch, the third thruster will burn to deploy Webb into the final position of its orbit, about 1 million miles away from Earth. Now the ground crew will align and focus Webb's primary mirror segments into a perfect monolithic mirror in upcoming months. It will take about 6 months until the James Webb telescope is fully functional to capture its first image. He is most recognized for his role in NASA's Apollo lunar mission, not for his scientific contributions. Many individuals believe that James E. Webb, who led NASA from February 1961 to October 1968, did more for science than any other government official, and that it is only fitting that the Next Generation Space Telescope be named in his honor. Those ideas are supported by Webb's record of support for space research and technology. Kennedy had pledged to place a man on the moon by the decade's end, but Webb thought that space exploration was more than just a political contest. A balance between human space travel and science, he said, would boost the nation's colleges and aerospace sector. William Shakespeare said, "What is in the name? Maybe not a lot, but it matters." This is where the James Webb Telescope's name might be in danger. Watch the full video and let us know in the comments if you think the Webb Telescope needs to be renamed. Some individuals feel that NASA's present intention to launch this wonderful device into orbit with the name of a guy whose legacy is at best ambiguous and at worst indicates involvement in homophobic discrimination inside the federal government. As a leader, he was responsible for executing government policy at the time, which called for the expulsion of LGBT persons from the labor force. According to Scientific American, historian David K. Johnson's 2004 book on the issue, The Lavender Scare, analyzes archival evidence showing that Webb, along with others in State Department leadership, was involved in Senate debates that led to a disastrous sequence of government legislation. About 6 years ago, suspicions of Webb's participation in persecution drew more public attention. Despite the disappointment of some astronomers at the time, many in the community thought the chance to rename the telescope had passed them by. In a recent unreviewed blog post, an astronomer sought to dispute Webb's bad reputation, stressing the fact that a homophobic statement was misattributed to Webb on his Wikipedia page. On social media, astronomers began to dispute that it was difficult to show that Webb was accountable for homophobic practices without this exact remark. In short, there is very little to no evidence that James E. Webb was a homophobe. So will the Webb be renamed? What do you think?